Hello. This is a new series I'm attempting where a group of my friends pick someone from their group to write a story with a random chosen idea, with the only rule being you're not allowed to fix your mistakes. I am reading the end result for the first time. Our kitchen appliances were arguing again. As per usual. That's normal. He requests me to produce coffee at least 10 times a day. That sounds like a lot of coffee. Never mind that the human body has 46 chromosomes. Holy! Or that we can splice our DNA perfectly with the strains of fungus or something disastrous like that. Why would you do that? It's necessity. It is freaking cooks in here. Oh no. If we weren't stationed at what was left of our The engineers thought they could use the ice to help cool the temperatures down. Too bad ice melts. I just want to go back to work. Becky the toaster spoke out. Becky, let me smash. Becky, let me smash. Becky, let me toast. Didn't help any better that Butler much perverted. Butler spat, his vocal synthesizer crackling. You wout. You wout? A friend? Tosh? You've only been installed for 3 weeks. 3 bloody weeks. Yo, you young kettle. Yo, you young kettle. Why is there a tab there? The lights on the butler's smooth frame flickered in rapid three blink unisons. Isn't that right, Daniel? I'm not your only... I read that wrong. You do love me. Oh god, no. I facepalmed. Daniel has declared his undying love for me, and me alone, you daft simpleton. Emily walked into the kitchen, still in her lab coat. Curly strands, oakish hair tumbled. Butler chuckled. You mean Mr. Butler, I presume. I assume. Johnny, get some water boiled for the night's lady here, you twat. The light at the base of Johnny... His kitchen is now becoming well-oiled machine with your help, Johnny. You're nothing but a bully and you... Oh my goodness! He yelled as I drew Emily in for a kiss. Along, mind you. The others gasped in surprise as our lip... The others gasped in surprise as our lip... The others gasped in surprise as... The others gasped in surprise... I meekly said before I felt my cheeks burn with Emily's backhand. Ow! I said pathetically. Her eyes were sharp with knife-like eyes. Her eyes were sharp with knife-like eyes. I can't. Oh my goodness. I want a drawing of that now. Whew. Emily strode out of the kitchen, back out, mug in hand. Wait. Emily strode out of the kitchen, back out. Emily? What do you mean, precisely? I leaned forward cautiously. Oh, nothing, she said nonchalantly.